The software-defined product is by nature highly abstract, consisting of code and data science. To bring things back to earth, let's examine a software-defined spring to reinforce the concepts learned so far. The software-defined spring will be defined at the part level. And as mentioned before, it will consist of the digital twin, which is its data and models, and its applications. Going back to our high school physics, the simple equation F equals kx represents the functionality of the spring. Apply a positive force, and there'll be elongation. Apply a negative force, and there will be compression. Although good for explaining how a spring works at a high level, in the real world, this just isn't accurate enough. It's not accurate enough because of all the other variables that come into play in the real world, in vitro. To get a more realistic picture of the spring, we need more data and more sophisticated models. What is the size of the spring? What's the gauge of the spring? What material is the spring made out of? What's the geometry of the spring? And what's its temperature and the environment that it's in? This data about the data is called metadata, and it is one of two types of data captured by the digital twin. Raw point data is a second form of data captured by the digital twin. It is collected by sensors, it's time-based, and it represents cause and effect. In this simple example, force and extension data is collected by sensors to get a better understanding of how the spring actually works within its environment. Again, the digital twin consists of data and models, and the data consists of metadata and raw data. The digital twin's models also consist of two types, metamodels and stochastic and parametric models. Similar to metadata, the metamodel is a model about the models. This informs the analytics on how the model operates at a high level. If, for example, gravity was involved, the metamodel would capture this, so we don't have to statistically determine that we're observing gravity. If we want to start analyzing the spring, we use its raw data, but in an IoT system, that can be hundreds of thousands or even millions of points, making it impractical to compute. Therefore, we come up with a stochastic model that represents, like a proxy, the raw data points. Whereas the high-level meta model was a linear equation, our model will be a nonlinear equation, the degree of which depends on the accuracy we need. But it will not be a straight line. These stochastic models are statistical models, and they're used by analytics, whereas parametric models are designed to be executed quickly and are used by the application. A nice way to think about this is stochastic models are used to look into the past and into the future with analytics, whereas parametric models are used to look at the present with the application. To simulate even the simplest of products, a spring, it needs to be represented with a sophisticated digital twin, again, consisting of two types of data and two types of models. And note that this is a digital representation of not how it looks, but what it does and how it operates. Next, we consider the application of the software-defined spring. This is the code that's used to execute the digital twins, or the models, in different situations. For example, if this was the spring in a suspension of an automobile, the application code would apply forces that would then execute on the model. Apply the force to the model cause and effect and get the resulting compression or elongation. Our digital twin and model are only looking at forces and compression or elongation. However, if our model took into consideration temperature and the environment, our application code could also change those variables and see what happens to the model. So together, the digital twin and the application code are a simulation of the spring in the context of the product, or in this case, the part being simulated. That's the software-defined spring. It has the model, or the digital twin, that also includes the data, plus the application. But remember, there was the trio of value. That consisted of the application, the digital twin, and the analytics. So if we were to analyze the software-defined spring, we could do it in a few different ways. In all cases, we are correlating the meta and raw data through an analyzable and executable model to look in the past by analyzing, let's say, past anomalies. What happened? By looking into the present, ensuring that the spring, for example, is operating properly in real time, and looking into the future. Perhaps we could analyze it based on past performances of similar springs to make predictions as to when the spring may crack or stop working properly. This is an example of a software-defined product at the part level. But as mentioned earlier, it can be simulated at different levels. At the part level, it's a spring. Perhaps at the product level, we would be defining a software-defined suspension. At the system level, we would be defining a software-defined car. And at the environment level, we'd be defining a smart city in which the software-defined car could operate. The simulation of even the most simple of products, like a spring, takes non-trivial computing resources in order to execute the code and the data science involved. Most IoT products will be far more complex, represented with a hierarchy of data, models, and code to achieve a realistic simulation.